has a very unusual hat. I wonder what's under a hat such as that. Could it be the creature they call the Gazette, who balances things on its head because it's flat? Or maybe a stripe-loving pipester from Upper Mount Bat? Or maybe a sort of a hat-wearing cat?
I can see that you've got quite a mind for your age. Why, one thing, and you drag me right onto the stage. Now I'm here. There's no telling what may ensue. With a cat, it's just me, and a thinker like you. Oh, the things you can think. Oh, the things you can think, if you're willing to try. Think invisible ink, or a gink with a stink, or a stare to the sky. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose. Oh, the things you can think when you think about Seuss. Oh, the things you can think, any thinker who thinks can come up with a few. Oh, the things you can think, think a trip on a ship to the Vip or a Vip or to Solid Salute. Think a beautiful schlock with a cherry on top. You don't need an excuse. Oh, the things you can think when you think about Seuss.
Think of an elephant hopping a tree.
Think of a person too tiny to see.
Think the one feathered tail
going on adventure down a dangerous trail.
Ah, think
bird who flies off on a spree.
Think
ceaseless trouble in store. Think of something horrible and hairy, something sinister and scary that you've never dared to think of before.
Think of nobody here, and the feeling of fear, and the darkness of night. Ooh.
All alone in your room, as you're facing your doom,
think a glimmer of light. Oh, but I hope you're prepared to be scarier than scared, cause it's a Mother Goose. Danger's right on the brink when you think about Seuss.
Story will soon be unfurled of an elephant trying to save a small world and a boy from that world who thinks just like you, just think
from the planet of who
and the smallest of small
to the jungle of Nool
and the largest of all.
You think and think,
oh, the things you can think. Think and wonder and dream far and wide as you dare.
Oh, the things you can think
when your things have run dry. In the blink of an eye, there's another thing there. If you open your mind, oh, the things you will find, lining up to get loose.
Oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think.
Oh, the things you can think when you think about two. Our story begins with a very strange sound. The drums of a jungle beginning to pound. Now imagine a sky.
I'll imagine it bright and blue.
It's the jungle of Nool.
Near the river of Waterloo.
Now think of an elephant lumbering through
Horton!
Yes, Horton!
Horton hears a who!
The 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the cool of the pool, he was splashing, enjoying the jungle's great joys, when Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant,
Horton the elephant, heard a small noise.
Help!
He looked toward the sound.
That's funny,
thought Horton.
There's no one around.
Then he heard it again.
Just a very faint yelp.
As if some tiny person were calling for help. I'll help you,
said Horton.
But who are you and where?
He looked and he looked. He could see nothing there.
But a small speck of dust blowing past.
Shh.
Through the air.
I say, how confusing. I've never heard tell of a small speck of dust that's able to yell. So you know what I think? I think there must be a person on top of that small speck of dust. Some poor little person who's shaking in fear. It'll blow in the pool. He has no way to steer. He's alone in the universe. I'll just have to save him, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small. Down there, and what's more, quite likely there's two, even three, even four.
Ha! Laughed a voice.
Ha! Laughed some others.
Ha! Ha! Ha!
Laughed a Wickersham brothers.
Oh, we should be playing pool in the jungle of Noor, and monkeys like us should know.
Now,
we're staying out on a limb, looking down on him.
And he's fat.
He's dope.
He's slow.
Elephants ain't too swift as a rule, but he's the biggest blame fool in the jungle of Noor. Cause he's talking to a speck, talking to a speck, to a speck of dust.
Blame fool in the jungle of Noor.
He's talking to a speck, talking to a speck, to a speck of dust.
Blame fool in the jungle of Noor.
R-E-S-P-E-C-K. Oh, please take that speck away.
Did you hear, did you hear, did you hear?
Through the jungle, the news quickly flew.
Did you hear, did you hear, did you hear?
He talks to a dust speck.
On channel 2. Our topic today is psychic elephants. Who hear voices? What do you think, folks? Is the elephant off its front? We'll be right back with Speck, Clover, Dust, Neighbor. Who? Nothing! Stay tuned! We'll be right back.
Biggest playing fool in the jungle of Noor.
I'm Virgin McFuzz, and I live right next door. He's never done anything crazy before.
Biggest blank fool, jungle of Noor.
He's always been friendly and loyal and kind. I just believe Horton's out of his mind.
Did you hear? Did you hear? Did you hear?
I'm Maisie LaBird, and I live in that tree.
Did you hear?
Enough about Horton. Let's talk about me.
Let's talk about me. Talking to a speck of dust.
I just have to save them, because after all, a person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how.
Biggest blind fool in the jungle of no, he's the worst we ever saw. Telling lies, making jokes,
but hoax!
That's against the law.
Breaking the peace, creating the fuss.
Somebody sing it different than us.
Biggest blind fool in the jungle of no, no, no. In the jungle of no, no, no. In the jungle of no.
Now enters the story.
Who?
You.
Hello? Are you there?
Hello?
Where? Who's here? We are. Who's here? Smaller than the eye can see. It's true, sir. We're who's who, sir. I'm a who.
So are we. We're tiny little people flowing by in the air, wondering how and why. We're who? The
wife.
Who?
Just imagine
the Who's unusual life.
Picture the tiniest houses and grocery stores. Tiny umbrellas that drip on the tiniest floors. The tiniest bubbles and tiniest streets. Miniature buses with miniature seats. Miniature buildings with miniature windows and doors.
No smaller town than yours.
To be totally mean.
You think that it's heaven on earth? Yes, you do!
But heaven on earth isn't heaven on you. Troubles on you are the biggest that you've ever seen. Here on earth, we live in fear, resisting space, and then on here,
I won't let you down. I won't let you fall.
A person's a person, no matter how small. A person's a person, no matter how small.
Here's our tiny Hoop family on a small rainy day.
Mom and Dad are just home from the Hoop PTA.
He was Mommy's little boy.
He was Daddy's little man.
He was never any trouble till this thinking thing began.
We must move down the wall.
Will he hate us?
Maybe so.
Oh, where are the instructions on how to raise a child? Who is the instructions on how to raise a child? Who is all the answers? I don't know.
Jojo, I'm the mayor of Hill. Why, I've just been elected. In upright behavior is thus forth expected.
We've just had a talk with your teachers today, and they didn't have one single good thing to say.
Your thinks were so wild they disrupted your classes.
You made Miss Mackle drop her new glasses.
You've invented new things which defy all description. And they, Miss O'Dooley, have a nervous conniption, which is why you're suspended.
Yes, that's what they said.
Young man, what and who has got into your head? The Horton has found us. We're safe on the clover. But clearly our troubles are far, far from over.
We don't mean to scold you. We love you, oh yes, dear. But couldn't you try thinking just a little bit less, dear?
Stop telling such outlandish tales.
Stop turning minnows into whales.
Now take your bath and go to bed.
And think some normal things instead.
You got me in trouble. Get out! Go away!
All right, I'll be going.
But first, let me say...
Oh, the things you can think!
Stop!
Oh, the things you can think! As you splash and you splish...
I'm not listening!
As you...
La 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 la!
Have a thinking that's up! Think of water and fish!
Fish?
Think of pipes in the floor, leading off to a shore, where the water is cool!
Soon your tub's not a tub. It's McGilligan's pool!
This might be a pool like I've read in the books, connected to one of those underground brooks. An underground river that starts here and flows right under this bathtub, and then who knows, it's possible. Anything's possible. This might go along down where no one can see, right under State Highway 203, right under the wagon, right under the toes of Mrs. Ambrosio, who's hanging out close. It's possible. Anything's possible.
It's possible. Anything's possible.
This might be a river now, mightn't it be? Connecting McGilligan's pool with the sea. And maybe some fish might be swimming toward me.
Thank you.
McGilligan's pool. It's possible.
It's possible.
Anything's
possible.
It's possible.
It's possible.
Anything's possible. It's possible. Anything. Anything.
Ceiling is peeling, you flooded the den. Oh, Jojo, I think you've been thinking again.
I say this with great firmness and terrible sorrow, but young man, we will deal with you come tomorrow.
I still think that I'm not such a fool when I sit here and McGilligan's pool.
It's possible.
I've been carting this clover for over a week, getting laughed at while thinking, well, a dustbag can speak. Well, let them all laugh. I'll try not to mind, for I have found something they'll never find.
There are secrets on a leaf, in the water, in the air, in a planet's tiny worlds, all invisible. Not a person seems to know, not a person seems to care. There's no one who believes a thing I say. Well, I'm fairly certain at one time or other, great thinkers all feel this way. I'm alone in the universe, so alone in the universe. I found magic, but they won't see it. They all call me a lunatic. Okay, call me a lunatic. If I stand on my own, so be it. 'Cause I have wings. Yes, I can fly around the moon and far beyond the sky. And one day soon, I know there you'll be. One small voice in the universe, one true friend in the universe, who believes in me. Alone in the universe.
No one notices anything. Not one person is listening. They don't have any way of knowing.
Nobody knows that I have wings.
I have wings.
Yes, I can fly.
I can fly
around the moon and far beyond the sky. And one day soon, you will hear my plea. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Please believe in me.
Hello? Hello?
Hello?
Who's there?
It's me, Jojo, the mayor's son.
I'm Horton. The elephant.
Are you real? Or are you a very large thing?
Oh, I'm
real, all right. I would state that in ink.
In my thinks, I imagine a lot of strange things, and I go to strange places, as if I had wings. I love a good think.
Well, for me that goes double.
Sometimes, my thinks would get me in trouble.
When you think, do you dream?
In bright colors.
Me too, and I go to strange places like Sala Salu.
When you dream, do you think you could fly to the stars?
Oh, little friend, no one else could have thinks such as ours. Yes, I have wings.
I have wings.
And I can fly.
I can fly
around the moon and far beyond the sky. You called my name and you set me free. One small voice in the universe.
One true friend in the universe.
Who believes in me? Good night, Jojo.
Good night, Horton. I'll see you in Sala Salu.
Wake up! The scene's over. There's more to be heard. There goes our hero. Who enters?
The bird!
Love Song for Horton, number 437. But it wasn't enough, for no matter what, it just was what it was. A tale that simply wasn't meant to catch the eye of an elephant. The one feathered tail of Miss Gertrude McFuzz. Poor little Gertrude, a sorry sight. Well, I'm gonna take you under my wing, and baby, you'll be all right. I was once a plain little bird like you, kid. One pathetic feather was all I grew. I had nothing show-off-ish. What's a plain bird to do? And there's certainly nothing show-off-ish on you. Thank you, Macy.
Then I made a plan for my self-improvement. No more crumbs, I vowed I would have the cake. Yes, I went to the doctor.
Doctor Dave by the lake.
And he told me what sort of a pill I should take. Now
Fabulous tale.
Get those pills and you can have frills.
she flew to the doctor named Dake, whose office was high on a tree by the lake, and she cried, "Dr. Dake."
"Tut, tut," said the doctor. "Such talk is too absurd. Your tail is just right for your kind of bird."
Then Gertrude had tantrum. She raised such a din that finally the doctor just had to give in.
"All right, already. Bring in the pillberry bush!"
Gulp. 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 Gulp.
What was that? Something's itching me. What was that? Something's twitching me. What was that? Are those feathers I see? I think my tail's beginning. Oh my word, this is wonderful. Second, third. Wow, I'm colorful. What a bird I'm beginning to be. Amazing Gertrude.
Just look at that tail, she is sporting.
Amazing Gertrude. Thank you, Dr. Day.
Thanks, Doc. Amazing Gertrude.
And hopefully I'll impress Horton.
Amazing Gertrude.
One more pill will do me good. Yes, it will. One more, one more, one more pill.
Soon she'll have the biggest tail. She'll have the biggest tail.
I'll have the biggest tail.
The biggest tail of
all.
Gertrude is happy. Her tail is so long.
Kid, fasten your seatbelt, because now things go wrong.
There's a rustle in the bushes. There's a tremble in the trees. Hear it like a whisper. Smell it on the summer breeze. Something big is getting nearer. Something big is coming through. Got some honking business. That's what we intend to do.
Come on, I want a monkey, monkey around. Come on, I got a monkey, monkey around. Come on, we're gonna monkey, ooh, we're gonna monkey around.
Ooh. The Wickershams, hello?
Well, it's bigger than a bread box.
Okay.
Well, it's wider than a whale.
Peanut butter bread.
And scared to death from head to tail.
So you're still talking to dust? Oh, that's hot.
A dust speck that's awful who's.
Who are not?
There aren't any who's where I don't hear a sound.
Come on, we're gonna monkey around.
Hey, give that back.
Up into the sky, then over the mountains, 10,000 feet high, then down from the mountains and into the news. When horse and the elephant chasing the hooves, chasing the hooves, chasing the hooves.
This cat and hat live from Sky Cam 5. Folks, the jungle of Null is one heck of a drive. We've got monkeys backed up to the 302. I'd find alternate routes if I were you.
Then over the desert of trees, and into the forest with thousands of trees, past beaches on beaches,
it's our kangaroo.
chasing you, Dust? Why, it's safe as can be.
We're monkeys to trust, or don't you agree?
Just to be sure, we're handing it off to a
black-bottom eagle named
Wait! Stop! Wait! I'll find it or bust. I shall find my small friends on their small speck of dust. Yes, clover by clover and clover with care, I'll listen and call. Are you there? Are you there?
Taking all my courage to approach you, not to mention all my stamina to follow you across the hills and deserts. But I feel as if I'm ready to confess to you the feelings that I've hidden, great diligence and labor. Behind the facade of your odd little next door neighbor, my eyes are too small, I have very large feet, and I'm not very proud of my pitiful tweet. But I've now got a tail, which is something to see.
102, 103.
Oh, notice me, Horton, feather by feather. This is your next door neighbor calling. Notice me, Horton, Horton together, we could be great. Oh, notice me, Horton, put down the clover. This is your next door neighbor calling. There's a new leaf your neighbor's turned over.
Over and over, clover by clover. I was just a no one only yesterday. You showed up and showed me something more. Now I've become a someone who has someone to believe in and to be there.
I noticed your kind and your powerful heart. So notice me, Horton.
Oh, the world would be something new.
Notice me, Horton.
If they noticed a thing or two.
Notice me, Horton.
The way I notice you. $2,999,999. This is hopeless.
You said it, kid.
What? Who's there?
It's me. Up here.
Maisie? Are you on a nest?
Yeah, you want to make something of it.
No. Just never thought I'd see you on a nest.
Neither did I, Hort. Neither did I.
Mm-hmm.
da 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 da. I was down in Fort Worth, just a girl on the wing. Then I met sweet Big Firth. Oh, how that night I'll sing. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
We spent 3 weeks of bliss and the usual sin. He flew off to St. Juan, leaving me with this egg. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky you are.
Still, I'm bored, I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required? I'd much rather play. I need a vacation, I'm due for some rest. Hey, Horton, would you maybe like to sit on my nest?
Why, Maisie, I couldn't. Of all silly things, I haven't got feathers, and nor have I have wings. And not only that, but I'm here on a surge. I just couldn't leave my poor hoos in the lurch.
I won't be gone long, kid. I give you my word. I'll hurry right back, because I'm that sort of bird. Oh, Horton, I'll fly back real soon. I'd only be gone for, say, one afternoon.
Well, I guess we all really need vacations from time to time. All right, I'll sit on your nest. And I'll try not to break it. But please come back quickly. 1 hour. Maybe two. I've got to find JoJo. I've got to save who?
Hit it, cat!
Thanks! Thanks a million! Goodbye!
Then carefully, tenderly, gently he crept up the trunk to the nest where the little egg slept. Then Horton the elephant smiled.
No, that's that.
And he sat and he sat and he sat and he sat. He sat all that day and he kept the egg warm. He sat all that night through a terrible storm.
I'm cold and I'm wet and I'm catching the flu. Oh, Maisie, please hurry, I've got to save who? Oh, Maisie, please hurry, I've got to save who?
Horton, I brought you a scarf.
Thank you, Gertrude. Have you heard from Maisie?
She sent a card from Palm Beach.
Palm Beach? Gertrude, what if she never ever comes back?
I'm sure she will. Horton, notice anything different?
Yeah, it's, getting colder.
And then came the winter, the snow and the sleet, and icicles hung from his trunk and his feet.
I can't leave this nest. No, I meant what I said. This egg might get frozen, but the who's might be dead. I can't say no when I heard Maisie beg. Now I'm caught between a suspect and an incubating egg. Hunters, help! Someone help! Hunters!
Just a
was tired and hungry and cold.
Egg, nest, and tree.
Then Horton was taken to auction.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Seussical. Our first item on the bid this evening is Lot 39, a pendulous pachyderm on egg, nest, and tree. The bidding will begin at $10,000. Do I hear $10,000? $10,000. $15,000. $15,000. Going once, going twice, and sold to the man with the sideburns and the greasy black mustache. Oh, excuse me, madam. Sold instead to the man from the circus.
Sold. Egg, nest, and tree.
Sold to the circus.
Down in Palm Beach with the breeze in your hair, and you don't have an egg or a nest or a care. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
How lucky
you are. When it's day after day, after beautiful day, to be lazing away by the sea with runs. Tell yourself how lucky you are.
Oh, you're so lucky.
Still, I'm bored, I'm cranky and tired, sitting day after day. Who knew so much work was required for nothing but play? I need something different, I crave something new. Hey, maybe could you think of something different to do?
Step right up, ladies and gentlemen, children and creatures, the smallest of the small and the tallest of the tall. Come old and come young, come one and all to the Circus McGurkus, the world's greatest show on the face of the earth, or, I mean, wherever you go.
A circus. I love a show. I think I'll go. Gracious, I've seen you before. Now let's see.
Why, Maisie, it's Horton, it's me, don't you remember? I've sat on your egg now for 51 weeks. I've sat here while people have paid to take peeks. I've sat here through lightning and hailstorms and snow. Won't you take back your egg?
Gee, I really don't know. Oh wow, it's really late. And gee, I've got a date. And lots of places to be, but it's so great to see you. Look at you. Who would ever guess? Look at you, such a big success. And it's all thanks to me. Amazing Horton, that exiting circus sensation. Amazing Horton, even I'm impressed. Amazing Horton, while I was off taking vacation, you made your fortune upon Maisie's nest. I may be unreliable, fancy free, irresponsible, crazy me, always eager to fly. But seeing you gives me true delight. Just this once, I've done something right. The egg is all yours now.
Wait, what?
No, don't thank me. I'll cry. Good luck when it hatches. Good luck. And goodbye.
No!
I said what I meant, and I meant what I said. An elephant's faithful 100%. And now, little egg, you're alone in the universe too. Who would have thought you'd be left up to me? A fool of an elephant up in a tree. Well, this time I swear I'll do better than try. I'll protect you from harm. Yes, I'll do it or die. So rest now, young egg, and I'll sing you a lullaby. A faraway land, so the stories all tell, somewhere beyond the horizon. If we can find it, then all will be well. Troubles there are few, someday we'll go to Salasalu. Salasalu, salasalu, salasalu. I've had so much trouble finding my way there. When I get close, it disappears. If we can get there, we're gonna stay there. If it takes us miles,
if it takes us miles,
if it takes us years. I've lost my poor Hoos and my friend Chojo too. I hope they all made it to Salasalu. High on a mountain or lost on the sea, sooner or later I'll find it.
I have a picture of how it will be
on the day I do.
Troubles will be through. I'll be home with you. Salasalu. Salu, sala, salu, sala, salu, sala, salu,
sala, salu.
I'll be
I bet you forgot about Gertrude McFuzz. Well, that's nothing new. I mean, everyone does. But Gertrude did something that few birds could do. This is the tale of Miss Gertrude, part two. Psst. Horton. there?
Would you mind a knock next to Gertrude?
Oh, Horton, I was so worried. Are you all right?
Gertrude, how did you find us?
Well, it's a long story. I had a little trouble because I grew a little tail. Well, it wasn't really little, it was absolutely giant, and it really was attractive, but you never even noticed, so I felt a little silly even trying. Besides, which the tail was too heavy for normal flying. So I ran to the doctor.
The doctor named Dake, and she said,
my tail has been a mistake.
She said,
Dr. Dake, I've been foolish and vain. Pluck it out, get it off, I won't do it again.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ouch, it hurt a lot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Ooh, a tender spot.
Pluck, pluck, pluck.
Just one feather tail.
Then suddenly, Gertrude could sail.
I sailed on a junk and was practically sunk for you. I scrambled through the trees full of furious bees for you. I slogged through fog and a choking smog. Now the soggy slope through a stinking bog. While my slip was gripped by a vicious dog. For you, all for you.
All for you.
All for you.
All for you.
There's nothing that I wouldn't and I couldn't. And I haven't gone through. I spray my love, I hobble like so for you. Then came the hit run, but I staggered on one for you. Now here I am, the worst for wear. And here you are.
I'm here. You're there.
And maybe. Yes, and Horton, one more thing. It took me 7 weeks, but I found your clover too.
Gertrude. Gertrude, I never noticed. You are amazing!
Aw, it was nothing.
Hello? Who's? Are you there? Hello?
Hello? Hello!
Mr. Mayor, is JoJo all right?
Hi, Horton!
Oh, JoJo, hello! Kid, now that I've got you, I won't let you go. I'll shelter and guard you, after all. A person's a person, no matter how small.
A person's a person, no matter how.
Ha!
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 How did you get here?
Stop! Where are you taking me?
Well, Horton, we're taking you back. You're gonna be going in style. We're talking to a spec, sitting on a neck. You're gonna be put on trial.
This is the case of the people versus Horton the elephant.
Horton the elephant.
Judge Yurtle the turtle presiding, everyone rise.
Order, order, order in the court.
Order, 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 order in the court.
The defendant is charged.
charged with talking to a speck, disturbing the peace, and loitering on an egg.
Hey, Your Honor, this clover is Exhibit A. There, who's here? There are who's here? Smaller than the eye can see.
Biggest play fool in the jungle, no!
It's true, sir. There are who's here? He's a who and so is she.
Biggest play fool in the jungle, no! Talking to a speck, talking to a speck, to a speck of dust.
Objection!
Overrule.
Sitting on an egg, sitting on an egg, sitting on an egg.
Objection!
Overrule.
I said what I meant, and I meant what I said. An elephant's faithful 100%. You can throw me in a jail, lock me up in a zoo, but I won't desert my egg, and I will not abandon who. These who's, sir, win or lose, sir, whether you believe or not. They're here, they live in fear, and I'm the only friend they've got. You can do what you want with me, Your Honor, and I won't question why. But please save who? The tiniest planet in the sky.
Based on the evidence, I have no choice but to order the defendant, Horton the elephant, remanded to the null. I silent for the criminally insane. And as for the dust speck,
on that oil. Boil it or no? No, that you can't do. It's all full of persons. They'll prove it to you. Mr. Mayor, oh, Mr. Mayor. Oh, please, Mr. Mayor. Now you've got to prove that you really are there. So ring every doorbell. Send out every word. Make every who holler. Make every who heard.
Attention all who's. Attention all who's.
We've got to be heard.
There's no time to lose.
So send up a shout.
Make it loud and clear.
We are here. We are here.
We are here.
We are here.
Don't give up. I believe in you all. A person's a person, no matter how small. And your very small persons will have to die if you made yourselves heard. So please try.
We are here!
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 The fate of the who's rested squarely on him. But then came a think, a peculiar new word. The kind of word no one ever had heard.
Boil it!
We are
boil
here!
It. We are
boil
here!
It.
We are
stop!
Do you hear what I hear? Do you see what I mean? They made themselves heard, though they still can't be seen.
What the heck? They prove they are persons, no matter how small.
And their whole world was saved by the smallest of all.
How true, yes, how true. So, the sour king will. But from now on, you know what I plan to do? I plan to protect them with you. And the young kangaroo would have half said,
me too.
Their troubles were over. They hailed his great
yah!
And Jojo was honored as thinker nonstop.
Oh, Jojo's thinks will forever be heard.
Including this thing. Voice, because that's how a bird sings.
Gertrude, what will I do? I'm slow and I'm fat. All I know is the herb. He'll mean so much more than that.
I have wings. Yes, I can fly. You teach him earth, and I will teach him sky.
Just call my name, and I'll see.
Adventures were over. The sky became pink. Then guess what happened next?
Well, what do you think?
Seuss!